Hey everyone, this is Illuminati Games from the Discord Bot Maker Game Dev Group, and today we're pretty much going to discuss the parameters command and how you can use single and multiple parameters. Basically, it's pretty simple. All you're going to require 5 actions. The first one pretty much will check to see if the user created or has entered a command parameter. A parameter is anything that you entered after the command itself. Usually it's followed by a space. You can pretty much check that in the settings. And the parameter separators you can see here would be the space. So plus whatever is entered after the space. So that's pretty much, for those who have ever been wondering what that parameter separator is and what that letter is for, it's pretty much for the space bar. So the command prefix, the command name, and the space plus whatever is after the space would be considered a parameter. So basically what we did here is, being that we're going to check to see if the user entered in a command parameter, and you can get this parameter from the conditions tab. You go to conditions and check parameters. You can go ahead and pretty much select what type of condition you want to choose. Is it the number of parameters equals, you know, a certain amount of numbers? Is there a the number of parameters equals the number of mentioned users that you may enter? So let's say if you wanted to enter a message to about three users within your server, then you can select that and equals number 3. So that means that the command itself will require the number of mentioned users in the command to be equal, you know, three users. If false, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and continue the actions and just send a quick message letting them, the user, know that the command itself requires a parameter. If false, which means it, you know, being that we are want to select one parameter, it's less than the number of parameters 1. If true, we're going to continue the actions. If false, we're going to skip the next actions. And being that we have these commands here, if the number of parameters is not less than 1, then we would start our command sequence here, which would be skip the next actions. Number of actions to skip would be 2. The send message would be action number 1 to skip. The end action sequence would be number 2 action to skip. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And for the send message, being that if the command parameter is less than 1, which is true, we want to send them a message letting them know that a parameter needs to be entered. So for here, we just type in command and just give a brief exclamation of the proper usage. We can put here usage. So this would be the command in order, the proper usage command in order to trigger these actions here, action number 4 and action number 5. Now we put an action sequence here because we don't want, after the second action, the send message action, we don't want that to continue and display. Of course, this won't show anything, as it just stores the increment, the command parameter that the user has entered into a temporary variable. But it will send this message here, which is, you have stored the mentioned user parameter to parameters command. But that's not quite true, because we want them to let them know that they must use a parameter. Though now thinking about it, it probably still stores it and mention it, but there's no indication or output letting the user know that it has been completed. So basically, if the command parameter that they entered does equal one, then we do want to store the first parameter, which is the number one. Anything after the space, after the command and the space, would be considered parameter number one, and we can store it in a temp variable mentioned user. We always want to store anything that we store, we want to save it as a temp variable so that you can recall upon it when you click on the create a send message or embed message. So you can see for action number five, we selected a send message. We're going to send it to the same channel. And in the message, we're going to put you as store the mentioned user parameter into the parameters command. And as you can see here, we'll just put you enter the user, and the temp variable mentioned user will be whatever the user has entered as that first parameter. In our case, we can right click and select the temp variable that we stored in action number four, and that's basically it. Save the project and test run, and you pretty much can see a good understanding of how parameters work. So when you type in the exclamation point parameters command and no additional parameters, it would pretty much run, check the parameters. It'll send this message here. You require a parameter to be entered, and it'll stop the command sequence. If it is true, if you type in exclamation point parameters command space and at a mentioned user, it would pretty much check this parameter, being that it is true that we included a mentioned user. It's gonna skip these next two actions and start the command process at action number four with the one parameter that we saved as a mentioned user temporary variable. Being that we saved it, we created a send message, which pretty much just lets the player or the user know you enter the user, and it'll save whatever mentioned user they entered as the temp variable mentioned user we scored in command for. Click save and test run your project and test the command, and you should be good to go. So this is the Discord Bot Maker game dev group, and press that like button. Thanks.